Finally, all the cleaning is done, and we're ready to start putting this engine back together. Off camera, I finished cleaning up all the parts we're going to use. But first up, I dropped this engine onto the ground so that we can get all the core plugs back in. We'll start with the backside because these plugs would have been very difficult to get in with the engine on the stand. I've laid out all the old plugs and the new ones with a list of plugs I need to use to make sure nothing gets left out. For core plugs, like pretty much anything else you're gonna do in a car, there are many ways to do it. Everyone has their own way. Pretty much anything will work just fine. I'm gonna start off with this 500 grit sandpaper and just real lightly sand the inside bore. Doing that ensures a smooth and clean surface. I'm using brass plugs, which I think are nice because they're never gonna rust out, but steel plugs would work just fine. Some people will put sealant on plugs, but we're not gonna do that here. As long as everything is clean and put together carefully, sealant should not be necessary. When you install plugs without sealant, sometimes, like the one that I previously installed on this block, they'll weep just a little bit on the first startup, but the first time the engine gets up to temperature, they seal and are sealed forever. A little bit of WD-40, line up the text horizontal, because if you don't, you're a monster. Slide it in as far as it'll go. Take a socket that fits in there well. This is a 1 1/8 socket. You want to make sure everything stays straight and you do not push it in too far. You gotta be careful because once you have the whole lip deformed to fit in the hole, it'll start to slide in pretty quick. And basically, as far as depth, you just want to have the whole thing sitting beyond the bevel in the block. So I can give that one more tap. And that feels pretty good. So that's pretty much it. Just have to do that 9 times. If you use a steel hammer, they'll go in a lot faster, but you have to be much more careful not to drive them in too far. Before putting in the cam plug, I want to show something. If you look straight down, you can see that the oil hole on the cam bearing does not actually line up completely with the oil gallery on the block. This isn't ideal, but it's more important to have the bearings lined up with the journals of the cam than with the galleries on the block. The rule of thumb is, as long as the hole is less than half covered, and this is only about a third covered, then you're good to go. It doesn't look great, but the cam will get all the oil that it needs. Now we're gonna install the cam plug. Of course, be careful not to touch the bearing with your sandpaper. This one you have to clean up extra well, just to make sure you're not putting any grit in there right next to the bearing. Once it's clean, line up the plug. For this one, I'm gonna use a 36mm socket because it fits this plug just perfect. You wanna get it nice and straight, just as far as you have to. For the 3 rear oil gallery plugs, we're gonna use these shiny ones that came with the kit. The thinking here is that since these are external to the engine, they would be more susceptible to rust, so the ones with fresh plating stand a better chance. And for these, we're just gonna use a little bit of thread sealant. And get them nice and tight. And then do the same for the next two. And then we'll move up just a little bit and put this oil gallery plug in. Same deal, just a little bit of thread sealer. And we'll cinch it down tight. And then we'll come around to the front of the engine and get this 1/8 inch NPT plug. Of course, since the threads are so small, you want to be careful with this one. And now, the two front core plugs. I'm doing these on the ground because it's a little easier without the engine stand trying to roll away on you. Thank you. and then we'll install the three oil gallery plugs for the holes that we tapped. And as mentioned, when we tap these threads, you want to be absolutely sure you're not going to block up that front oil gallery. This short plug would have to be an eighth of an inch past flush to even start getting in the way. So I do not think we will have any problems. So when installed, the plug is just flush with the block. That means it's definitely not interfering with that oil gallery and also won't be anywhere near the cam gear. So there we go. For the rest of the plugs, we'll put the block back on the stand. So to lift this, by the way, I just have these two little hooks. Cardboard is just to protect the surfaces. I have a little bolt here holding the chains together in the hook. It's pretty balanced with the bolts in the center cylinder bolt holes. So remember, I already replaced this plug, but now we'll get the other three side plugs. Okay, that's all of the big plugs. So now let's get in this oil filter plug. And then the two coolant plugs. So now, the hidden plug under the main cap. You can see there's sort of two levels here. You want to get it past this first passage that I'm shining the light through and onto that second shoulder. If you don't put this plug in, the oil filter is bypassed all the way through this gallery. So I just wanted to try to install this plug and I realized it's a little bit big. These new ones measure 0.53 inches. The old ones measure 0.46 inches. That's a kind of significant difference if you look at that. I should have checked that beforehand. Since the Dorman kit didn't have the right parts, I ordered this kit from Pioneer. It was like $8. And I believe it has the plugs we need. Yep, that's our guy. This is the old one, this is the new one. I looked it up and eventually figured out these are 29/64 plugs. I have no idea which blocks have them because some people said it was like post 1986 and then some people said they had older blocks with these. So sometimes blocks have these smaller plugs instead of the half-inch ones. I have no idea why, and I sure wish Dorman would include these in their kits. This kit does seem to have everything you'd need, although it does have steel plugs, which are a bit inferior to the brass ones. So now we're going to install the plug that goes under the main cap. So now we know that this is a 29/64, but many of these use half-inch plugs here. To install this, the installed height you want is right about 1 3/8 inches from this block surface. So this is 1.5 inch bolt with a washer on it, which sets the depth to the center of the plug to just about 1 3/8 inches. All I'm gonna do is drop it. You have to make sure the plug is below this oil galley, but not into the next one. And all we're gonna do is tap it in. I said tap, but it actually took a fair amount of force. when it's in there. And we'll double check, but that should be 1 3/8". So measuring from the block surface to the center of that plug, you get 1.41. 1.375 would be 1 3/8". With that one washer, it's a little bit below that, but that is pretty close and we'll definitely be fine. So it looks like there's a little bit of debris from that, so I'm just gonna take this magnet and try to get all that out of there. And if you really want to double check, you can check from the oil pressure sender hole up to that plug. And it should be 8 3/8". Okay, so with that plug installed, we should be good to go to continue assembly.